fine morning indeed. We keep locking them up, but the bodies keep piling up.
Yeah, California's love affair, folks. As long as the bricks hold up at San Quentin, there'll always be killers in this town to save.
First the letter, and now another body. Come on, you can't keep on telling me there's not a killer still out there.
You know, Phelps, all these arrests on your record are giving you a reputation. You don't want them turning into unsolved.
Getting a vicious killer off the streets is more important than my reputation.
Really?
And besides, landing a big fat marlin is more impressive than an ocean full of minnows.
The minnows maketh the man, Phelps. You can't always hit home runs. Sometimes you just gotta make great kicks.
Crazy.
Well, I'm crazy. It's your fault. Running around behind my back. How am I supposed to trust you, goddammit?
Whoa, sir. I think you ought to calm down.
Mind your own goddamn business. Why is everybody always on my case?
Officer down! Watch it!
Hurt me.
Give it up, old man!
Get the bastard!
Reinforcements are on the way. Cease and desist.
Car 11K. Code 4 at Alvera Street, but I'll need an ambulance. Shots fired. Suspect is down.
Roger on your ambulance, 11 King. All units be advised, code 4 at the Alvera Street Plaza.
That guy there will lead us up.
I'm steeling myself for what I'm about to see.
That'll just be another dead body, partner. Get used to seeing them. They're the gig when you work a homicide, pal.
Detectives?
Phelps and Galloway, homicide.
Scene secure. The rest of the patrolmen are going door to door, canvassing for witnesses.
Thanks. Keep me informed.
Will do, Detective.
This looks awfully familiar. I think that's the impression the boys from the Examiner took with them as well.
There's nothing original under the sun. Why should murder be any different?
What do we have so far?
Not much trace evidence to speak of. Storm blew in around 10 last night, and the rain washed most of it away.
And the body?
Looks like she was tipped out of an automobile from the tire tracks and superficial injuries. Strangled with a length of rope. And for my money, it's triple braid again.
Time of death?
From her temperature, maybe 2 a.m. But it was cold last night.
Usual head injuries.
Blunt force trauma. Knock him over the head, then strangle and mutilate. No message with this one.
At least she was left clothed.
I doubt very much he was concerned with her dignity.
The green silk dress is very distinctive. Any sign of her other shoe?
No. And no handbag or other personal effects.
There appears to be a dry cleaning label. Superior Laundry Services, F1363.
Another day, another dollar.
Our driver and our killer are most likely one and the same. No drag marks. The killer was moving around, surveying the scene.
Detectives, I've been working the houses across the street and up the block. This lady thinks she has something for us.
Detective Feltz, LAPD.
I'm Mrs. Barton, Catherine Barton. I live just across the way.
Did you see anyone around here last night?
Not last night, but yesterday, early evening, I saw that awful hobo.
Do you have a description?
Tall, gaunt, horribly disfigured. I think he may have had an accident in the war. He's a very scary, angry man.
Any idea where we might find him?
One of the hobo camps around here. He's some kind of hobo leader. They all follow him around.
Thank you, ma'am. You've been a big help.
Of course. Anything I can do to help. I'd hate to think that something so ghastly could happen right here and nothing be done about it.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need an address on Superior Laundry Services.
Just a moment. Superior Laundry Services, 1260 West 1st Street.
Can you track down reports of hobo camps in the vicinity of Signal Hill?
Just a moment, Detective. There's a large camp under the bridge on Grand between Temple and Sunset.
Thanks for your help.
Angeles, California. KTI Radio 760.
No message.
Excuse me?
There was no message.
Where?
On the Vic. The last bodies had something written on it. This one didn't.
I'm failing to follow.
Can't be the same guys when you say that, right? Before you start trying to link this to Maldonado and all the others.
There are more factors to consider than the messages, Rusty.
This doesn't fit your pattern, Cole. End of conversation. Understand? Watch it, will you?
At least the rain stopped. You can change back into those white bucks now.
Phelps and Galloway, LAPD. We're investigating a case and one of your laundry labels came up. F1363.
If you give me a minute, I'll go find a register and you can take a look. You take a look for yourself. I've got clothes that need pressing.
You wrote the number down on that dress, is it there?
Mrs. T. Terrellson, 43 Emerald Street, Westlake.
I've got a feeling we're about to meet another wife killer.
You've always got that feeling, Rusty.
Yeah, and it's usually correct.
Please, please, for once, can you not let your assumptions color your detective work?
Just you wait. Nordic types show a particular disposition for this stuff.
Hello? Yes?
Detectives Phelps and Galloway. Is your wife home, sir?
My wife went out last night and she hasn't come home.
Can you describe your wife and what she was wearing?
We were out at a friend's place, Bobby Ross's, for a party. She was kind of dolled up. She had her green silk dress, open-toed white shoes. Those are her favorite shoes.
Can we come in, Mr. Terrellson? I'm afraid we have some rather bad news. Do you have someone who can look after your children, Mr. Terrellson?
I've been trying to arrange a sitter. Look, tell me what's happened.
I'm afraid your wife was murdered last night. Her body was found this morning. We're very sorry for your loss. I know this is a difficult time, Mr. Terrellson, but we are going to need you to answer some questions. First, we're going to take a look around.
What for? You don't think
that... procedure. You see to your girls.
stay here till Daddy's finished talking to these men.
Where's Mommy?
Everything's gonna be all right, sweetheart.
We would like Mommy to come home now, Daddy.
What's the problem, Terrelson? Let him search. You got nothing to hide. You want to hear something funny, Terrelson? Some bums think filling out a missing persons report actually rules him out as a suspect.
Need to check if she was a regular.
Circumstantial. Baron's Bar again. Someone must be real sweet on this dive. I wonder why the picture was turned down.
If you'd excuse me, ladies. So she went out without her handbag? She'd have to be in quite a state to leave this behind. At least she was spared that particular indignity. Lars was out in the rain last night. We could see if Pinker can match the impression to the crime scene. Like a match with the ligature marks. I'll be out of your way momentarily, ladies. Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
Can you run an address for a Bobby Ross? Then send some uniforms over.
Would you like him picked up?
No. Suspect says he was with Ross last night. We need to confirm the alibi.
I'll get a prowl car dispatched.
Thank you. For the record, Mr. Terrelson, what is your wife's name?
Teresa.
Do you have any idea why anyone would want to hurt your wife?
No. Everyone loved Teresa. She was so full of life. It can't be anyone who knew her.
I think you're lying, Lars. I think you were mad at your wife for embarrassing you in front of your friends. I think you came back here and strangled her and then dumped her body on the hill.
You think I strangled my wife? How do you expect to prove that?
Your wife was strangled with triple braid rope. The bowline from your boat is a perfect match.
Look, I know this looks bad. I'm gonna have to come to terms with the fact that I let her go.
You said you went to a party at Bobby Ross's place?
That's right, Bobby had a bunch of people over. We were having a good time. She said she was bored and decided to leave.
You let your drunk wife leave the party and go off on her own?
Look, I was angry. I was having a good time. She has to go and ruin it. We always have to do what she wants to do. Last night she wanted to go dancing.
Any idea where?
Where she always goes. A bar down on North Beaudry Avenue. Baron's Bar. She goes there, drinks too much, gets maudlin, and calls me. I go and bring her home.
Mr. Terrellson, was Teresa happy at home?
Yeah, I think she was.
Spill it, Terrellson. We like the look of you for this, so you better give us something.
We're at the party. She has a few and says she wants to go out dancing. We only have the sitter until 9. I get mad. I tell her to go ahead, but I'm staying. She storms out. Look, I'm doing well at cards. I hardly ever do well. I married her because she was so much fun, but now she drives me fucking crazy.
What time did she leave the party?
About 8:30, maybe a little earlier.
When was the last time you saw your wife?
Around 8:30. The card game at Bobby's was wrapping up. I played out my hand and drove home here. I paid the sitter and went to bed.
You're lying, Lars. You didn't come straight home, did you?
And how do you figure that?
You were out in the rain. You got soaked, Lars. We found your wet weather gear.
Okay, I stayed a little later than I said. This cute little brunette was hitting on me. Teresa noticed. I was half cut. I walked her home from Bobby's, but nothing happened. I walked back and got the car this morning.
Thanks for answering our questions, Mr. Terrellson. You'll need to go downtown to identify your wife's body.
I should have taken her dancing.
In my experience, Mac, if you give in to broads, you'll be giving in to them your entire life. Sounds like the Terrellson broad had her last drink at Baron's Bar. We should check the place out.
Appreciate your time, sir.
You believe this guy's story?
Kind of rings true.
National news from American Century Broadcasting.
Capitol Hill in Washington is again the nation's focal point as the 80th Congress convenes during one of the most crucial periods in the nation's history. Following the Republican landslide of 1946, the GOP now possesses a clear working majority in both branches of Congress. The Capitol awaits the...
Gents, drink?
Phelps and Galloway, LAPD.
I'm Benny Clough. This about Teresa Terrellson?
Yes, it is.
I heard about it on the radio. They're saying it was that Black Dahlia freak again? God damn it. Now, I rang that husband of hers. The babysitter said he was out.
If you don't mind, we have a few questions.
What time did Teresa leave?
Around 10:30, I think.
On foot, in a car, by bus, how was it?
She called for a cab.
Did you get the number?
Sure I did. I like Teresa. The only time she has a drink is when things aren't going so good at home. I was worried about her.
Two club sandwiches. Thank you, waitress.
Put out an APB on the cab.
3591. Should be traceable.
Who was she with? We've had reports about a tall, gaunt-looking hobo. He wasn't here last night?
I get plenty of bums in here, but nothing to fit that description.
The likelihood is that whoever she left here with killed her. Give it up, Benny.
All right, two creeps were all over her, promising to take her dancing.
You get a good look at these guys?
Sure. I got a good look. One of them was a sailor in uniform. His cap said, USS Indiana.
And the other man?
The other guy is Richard Bates. He's sitting in the back right now. Red polo shirt.
Any idea where she was headed?
Nope. I didn't get that.
The husband said she wanted to go dancing.
And she always wants to dance when she's been drinking. She was trying to talk some guys into taking her to one of the dance halls.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Clough. We'll take it from here.
Hey, no problem.
This is Bates.
That's him.
LAPD, don't make me chase you, shitbird. Can't let the son of a bitch get away. Go, Phelps, get after it.
Got a ride. Get in and drive.
I thought you were gonna leave me there.
Who knows what this guy will pull when he's cornered? We could have a killer on our hands.
Don't go to sleep on me. Get me back in close.
I don't think the killer would be kicking back in the bar where he met the Vic in.
Listen, a creature of habit is your killer. For some reason, they're sticklers for routine.
Hit him! Clean this asshole off the road. Keep it steady and I'll try to bust his tires.
Let's end this farce.
All right, you got me. I've had enough.
Put your hands where I can see them.
Okay, Bates, you're gonna answer some questions.
I have a choice in this.
Last night, you went drinking with a lady in the bar. Now she's dead, and your face is all messed up.
I'm in the clear on that. She preferred a sailor. You could lay it off on him. Are we finished?
Do you want my partner to sap you? Tell us what we want to know.
She was okay. Drunk. Pissed off at her old man, wanting to go dancing. I thought I'd ply her with a few drinks and get my end away. Looks like your salty had the same idea.
So what happened when you left the bar?
Sailor boy laid one on me. A cheap shot. After that, I don't know.
You've done time, haven't you, Richard? Is that why you ran?
I'm on parole.
On what offense?
Sexual assault. Look, I was lying there on the sidewalk. He flags a cab and jumps in with the broad.
We're taking you in, Bates.
How come?
Just for a chat. Nice private chat. I'll explain my theory of once a degenerate, always a degenerate.
Take him to Central. He's a material witness in a murder case. Find him a cozy cell.
Richard here knows the drill.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need an APB out on a yellow cab, number 3591. Ask dispatch to relay all sightings to car 11K.
No problem. I'll get on the radio.
Were there any incident reports filed in the vicinity of Baron's Bar on North Beaudry Avenue? We're tracking a sailor who was involved in a fight outside the bar.
I can check the reports, Detective. I have a message for you from Captain Donnelly. Message reads, James Jessup, U.S. Navy able seaman, has information relevant to your case. Jessup is currently being detained at Central Station.
Could be our man.
Thanks, ma'am.
On your APB regarding yellow cab number 3591. The vehicle has been identified at a gas station. Now heading west on 7th Street.
Garage on 7th Street. Let's hit it, Phelps. The cab driver might tie this whole thing together.
I hope you're right.
Yellow cab number 3591, sighted at the corner of Wilshire and Whitmer. Repeat, Wilshire and Whitmer, 11K.
You know, putting the siren on might remove the element of surprise from your hit and runs.
Where's that cab got to now? That's him there, Phelps. Hit the siren.
LAPD, we're investigating a murder.
What's that got to do with me?
The fare you picked up from Baron's Bar last night. What was the woman wearing?
It was a green dress. Oh, don't tell me something's happened to her.
Tell me about her.
She was with this sailor, and he was all over. She wasn't having any of it. Said she just wanted to dance. But he had that look in his eye.
Where did you drop them off?
It's at the Crystal Ballroom.
What time?
After midnight. 12:30? Something like that.
Thanks. You've been a big help.
Well, that's gonna ruin my day.
If we survive this, it's going to be a miracle.
That's that cop. Seems like a decent guy.
He's in interview two.
Thanks. What do you make of him?
Sailor on furlough, who looks like he's in trouble and knows it.
Yeah, I want to make homicide. You know you've got it made.
Detectives Phelps and Galloway. We know why you're here, Jessup. So it would be best if you answered our questions truthfully.
I don't want any trouble. That's why I'm here. I heard on the radio about this lady getting killed. I got leave from my CO to come down straight away.
So why did you kill her?
I didn't kill anyone. Look, you need to believe me.
Let's start at the beginning. You went to Baron's Bar. What time did you arrive?
I got a 24-hour pass. I got there around 7.
That's where you met Teresa Terrelson?
Sure. We had a couple of drinks.
So you tried to make a woman who was incredibly drunk?
Look, I'm not proud of myself, but I never hurt her.
You took her dancing?
That's right. Caught a cab to the Crystal Ballroom.
You had a fist fight with Richard Bates over Mrs. Terrelson.
You met the guy? He's a creep. You should take a look at him for this.
He's pointing the finger directly at you, Jessup.
I only had one night before I was back in the tub. He had all the time in the world to look for some action. I belted him. I'd do it again. She was better off with me.
Sure. You're a shining example of chivalry, Jessup. Where did you go after the Crystal Ballroom?
Oh, I think the wind had gone out of her sails by then. She caught a cab and I caught a bus back to the base.
We spoke to the cab driver. Tell us what really happened at the Crystal Ballroom.
I'd had enough. She was all upset about her husband bawling, about her kids. She looked old. Left around closing, maybe 1:30. We got on a bus and she fell asleep on my shoulder.
Which bus?
An All-American, 249. I went past her place. She jumped off and I stayed on it downtown. After that, I caught another bus to San Pedro. The Indiana's down there. She's being scrapped.
And that was the last you saw of Teresa?
Yeah, that's right. We didn't say much. I think she was kind of embarrassed.
The cab driver said that you were getting pretty familiar with Teresa.
That's not how I'd put it.
So the last thing you wanted was her playing hard to get. Did that make you mad, Sailor?
Yeah, it did. She knew what a guy's looking for. All broads do. Dancing comes second.
And what happened at the Crystal Ballroom?
Nothing. Not even a little hand relief. She had another couple of drinks. There was no fun left in her. Just poured her guts out to some bartender.
We're holding you till we can clear this with the driver.
Yeah, my CO said as much.
Can you put the guy in two in a cell and inform the commander?
Sure, detective. Got a message for you. Sighting of your disfigured hobo on Grand between Temple and Sunset. And it looks like the beau has a record, too. He's wanted in connection with 2 female assault.
Thanks.
What now? Drive all the way to San Pedro and check his locker?
Let's see if the bus story checks out.
There's a depot at 1660 Beverly Boulevard. Three suspects in the can and one on the hoof. And still no hard evidence on any of them.
KGPL to car 11K. 11K, come in.
11K, go ahead.
Patrolman reporting that Bobby Ross's car game is breaking up at midnight.
11K, roger that. Plenty of time to get downtown, Cole.
It's possible. Have them bring him in.
KGPL, we have Lars Terrelson picked up. You're gonna kill us!
56 Street,
And thank you, ma'am. You have a safe trip now. Where are you boys headed today?
LAPD. We're after the driver of All-American 249. Would have been around midnight onwards last night.
Just a minute. Frank Zeffirelli. He's your man.
Where can we find him?
Frank is out on the 7-4.
Can you tell us the route?
Hang on. I should have it mapped out here somewhere.
I'll need to run the loop.
We're not going to drive the whole thing, are we?
Won't take long. We have a siren.
Will you look at me?
And thank you, ma'am. You have a safe trip now. Where are you boys headed today?
LAPD. We're after the driver of All-American 249. Would have been around midnight onwards last night.
Just a minute. Frank Zeffirelli. He's your man.
Where can we find him?
Frank is out on the 74.
Can you tell us the route?
Hang on. I should have it mapped out here somewhere.
Need to run the loop.
We're not going to drive the whole thing, are we?
Won't take long. We have a siren.
All-American 74. Let's go get him. This could be a long trip, Cole.
Or it could be a short one.
And here's me without my hip flask and only a pain in the ass for company.
Which?
Whoa there!
Oh, jeez. Way to kick off the drive in high spirits, Rusty. Comments like that put me in just the right mood for some legwork.
Touchy.
You know what your problem is? You don't like hard work. This kind of rigorous search is what police work is all about. Discipline.
Save it, Phelps. You're just as bored as I am.
Nope, still no sign of him.
Did you doze off, Rusty? I think you slept through my solving the case.
Yeah, very funny. You just give me a nudge if you see him, all right?
How about you nudge me?
I think that's a job for your wife, Phelps.
Oh, Rusty.
There's the bus, Cole. Turn on the siren and pull her over. That's the bus we're looking for. Ease in behind her and get her to the side of the road. There's the bus, Cole. Turn on the siren and pull her over.
There's some kind of problem, buddy?
LAPD, we're investigating a murder. You had a sailor and a woman in a green dress on your bus late last night?
That's correct.
And the woman got off first, around 2 a.m.?
Yeah, that's right. And the sailor stayed on all the way to downtown.
Can you tell us where you let the woman off?
On California Street. To tell you the truth, she looked a little lost, like she got off on the wrong stop or something. I didn't like dropping her off near that hobo camp.
You've been a big help, Mr. Zeffirelli.
So Sailor Boy escaped by the seat of his bell-bottom trousers. He left the broad alive.
Left her by the hobo camp.
Which means he's as good as killed her.
We can't eliminate any of them. But the disfigured man should be our starting point.
I'm gonna call for some backup. These bows hate cops.
I think we ought to investigate the hobo lead.
Now, if you think we ought to, then I guess we ought.
Okay.
LAPD! We'd like a word with you.
Save it for someone who's interested. They're fascists! Come to move us on and steal what little we have left!
Six rounds won't get us far.
We need you to stay copacetic, Phelps. We need to hold out to the cavalry battle.
How do we do that?
Like this.
Buckshot, keep you down, Phelps.
If you want your rightful share, we need to
fight for it!
Make
you feel powerful.
Get your filthy hands off me, you bum.
What's your name?
Comrade Stalin.
Very funny. We'll find out from your personal effects.
Stuart Ackerman.
You're under suspicion for murder, Ackerman. We're taking you downtown.
You can't do anything more to me than what the Japanese have already done.
The Kremlin's over here, Phelps. Toss it and see what you find.
Still working, Jack. I'm off to the Lighthouse Club in Santa Monica.
Hello, Jack.
Mr. Benson, this is Courtney Sheldon. He's a buddy of mine from the war.
Well, I'm sure you two will want to polish some old war stories. Good evening, Jack. Mr. Sheldon.
Good night, sir. Take a seat, Courtney.
We need your help, Jack.
I told you I would have nothing to do with that.
I'm fine too, Jack. Medical school's going well. I got a part-time job.
Do dope peddlers need part-time jobs?
We made a mistake and we're in trouble, Jack. A local gangster, Mickey Cohen, is putting on the squeeze.
So hand it over, walk away. What's stopping you?
We had a deal with them that they would dole it out slowly. They said they would supply abortion clinics and doctors, but they've been moving it on to addicts and they can't cope with the purity.
So your problem is with gangsters being dishonest.
My problem is that people are dying and that if this gets back to us, we'll all end up in jail.
So how am I supposed to help, Courtney? This isn't the war. I can't just wave a magic wand and clean up your mess.
We want you to negotiate, Jack.
The only thing these guys understand is force, Sheldon. They got to the top back east by proving to be more vicious than the English, the Irish, and the Dutch. They make their own laws. That's the nature of a secret society. God's sake, Courtney, you want to be a doctor. How can you fight with that?
We are better trained, Jack.
I didn't make it through the war to come back to this kind of shit, Sheldon.
Looks familiar. Safe bet it'll match the mark under Teresa Terrellson's chin. Ackerman doesn't look like much of a dancer. I doubt it.
The husband has an alibi, but no real motive other than neglect. Jessup's alibi checks out. Bates is a recidivist. He'll be pulling the same stick until we put him away for good. Ackerman has history, opportunity, hard evidence. What motive?
We have the evidence. We know she was here. All we need is a confession, and we can charge the bum with murder.
5 this way.
Ackerman, you were in the Marines.
How do you know?
The Corps selected big guys for flamethrower duty. That's how you got the burns.
Life expectancy was 5 minutes for a guy in flamethrower detail. What kind of a government puts weight like that on a man's shoulders?
You'll get no argument from me. It was a heavy load.
You feeling sorry for this smelly fuck?
Why did you kill Mrs. Terrellson?
I have no recollection of the people I have killed.
Are you denying that you strangled Mrs. Terrellson with a length of rope?
I'm not denying anything. You have to have proof, lackey.
We found a matching piece of rope in your lean-to. I think we'll find the blood will match too.
I own no property. How could it belong to me?
A bus driver dropped Mrs. Terrellson near your camp around 2 a.m. Why did you take her up to the hill?
Which hill? I have many places. I go where I please.
You are clearly insane, Ackerman. The state of California does not execute mental patients.
I don't know the names of the women I've killed, but I've killed many of them. Their necks are so fragile.
Where were you around 2 a.m. last night?
At the camp.
You were up on the hill. You were seen during the day. We have a witness. We have evidence. Come clean with me, Ackerman, and I'll see what I can do for you.
I despise your pity. You have nothing that links me to this woman.
We have you cold, Ackerman. Her purse and the ballroom ticket were in your lean-to. Tell us why you did it.
I kill because people need killing. It's what I was trained to do.
Stuart Ackerman, I am charging you with the murder of Teresa Terrellson.
A man down on his luck, I can abide. But a filthy red who chooses to live outside the rules of society, I cannot stomach. Maybe poor Theresa Terrellson will provide the catalyst we need. I've spoken to the chief and the mayor, and I think it's time we send some men in to remove the godless and send them on their way over the county line. A grand day that will be, gentlemen. And a grand result you have brought me. You two are fast becoming my finest crusaders. Of course, we will look into it. Yes, I'm aware that it's an election year. Keep a hold of your hat, Counselor. Now is not the time to lose your nerve. It would appear that someone has hawked a rose gold wedding ring, a matching engagement ring. Sound familiar?
Deirdre Muller.
Press the pawnbroker and see what you can find out. The address is 348 South Main Street. The Muller case goes before the grand jury next week, and the DA does not want any egg on his face. Then get out to the railroad depot on Santa Fe Avenue. We have another poor unfortunate found this morning beside a railroad line. 40-year-old white woman.
Right, Skipper.
Another body, and Deirdre Muller's ring. The Emperor may soon have to come to terms with the fact that he's wearing no clothes.
Exactly. Did you get that book of riddles shoved up your ass, Phelps? Is that what your old man paid college tuition for?